All right, guys, so I just wanted to show you exactly what I found out with the second generation Acura TL center display. So I've been having issues with this one flickering, and a lot of times just not working altogether as I'm driving. I can't see what temperature or what radio station that I'm on, and just decided to take it apart, kind of take a look and see what's going on inside of it, see if I could fix it or if it needed to be replaced. So anyway, you need to take this out of the center console display area that has the AC vents, and it's going to be held on into that from the back with these Phillips head screwdriver screws, and those are just going to go basically in from the back in one of these holes. And that's going to hold it in. You're going to need, obviously, to get it out of the car and out of the center console, you're going to need to unplug this plug, and you're going to need to undo those screwdrivers, those screws. Once you take those out, then it's just a matter of these tabs opening up, and you can go ahead and pop those off. So this whole system comes out in pieces. So the first thing that you're going to do is the back. Okay. And it's going to look like you're doing the back. It's actually the front plastic cover. Okay. And that's going to take off this plastic cover. And then this is your LCD display. That's going to come off as well. Gonna do these little tabs. Bear with me, this is like one of the first videos I've done. Okay. I already did this, so I'm just kind of doing it in reverse order so you can see what I did. So I know that it worked. And I know a lot of these cars have this issue, so just kind of have to work at these ones, but it'll eventually come off. I'll take it and show you what we're looking at. These guys on the side, you gotta unpop those. This one here. And this whole back plate just kind of pops off. There we go. So as you can see, you have your motherboard in the back. And the difference between the RL and the TL is the RL is actually, it has these, I don't even know what you call those, they're like fingers that go from the LCD display and they connect directly to the motherboard. So the other RL helps that you've seen, it's not going to work on this because it doesn't have, this is not removable. It's actually all soldered together. They must put the LCD in first and then put the motherboard on, and then they solder all these little guys that connect the motherboard to the LCD. And so you can't actually physically take this motherboard off. And the area that you need to get to is right back here. You can see that my solder gun actually melted all of this area because you're gonna have to work in there without physically pulling this motherboard off. So what I did is you're just gonna gently and gingerly put pressure on this edge, and you're going to bend this down. What I ended up doing is you're going to flip this little guy down here, and you're going to start slowly bending this out. Okay, once you get it past these posts, what I did to give myself room to get my soldering gun in there is you're going to take a pencil, and you can just put it in there as a spacer, okay? And now area you need to get into are these little guys right here. You can see I've already soldered them. Okay, those were terrible looking. They were all broken, they were oxidized, and so knowing that the RL had issues with these pins, I was fairly confident that if I re-soldered those, that would be my issue, and that indeed was. So what I took and did was I just got some extra solder, stuck my soldering iron in there, and just each one of those, I melted it until the solder flowed, but stopped before it connects to another one. I had that issue with this guy right here, the one that's not sticking up as much. The pin actually slipped down. So what happened was those two bridged each other, and I'm sure that would have shorted something out. So I had to go back in there and work and pick it out so that they weren't touching anymore. So once I did that, put everything back together, take your pencil out. It's gonna snap closed like that. Give it a good little pinch, and that's gonna snap closed there. And you're just gonna put this back together in reverse order. So, just put this bad boy back on. There you go. And then you actually don't have to take this out. I took it out originally, but what you do have to do is put this plastic cover back on. I suppose you don't even have to take these off. You could just take off the back, but it gives you a better idea of exactly what's going on inside so that you can fix your problem. So literally, it probably took me half an hour, maybe 45 minutes to go through this, and it seems to be working great, no issues. I wiggle the cords, tap on this, and nothing seems to happen, so it seems like it's gonna be a good fix. So anyway, that's for your second generation TLs. Hopefully this helps you guys out, and you can comment on this video, you can share it as much as you need. I'm just trying to help everybody else out. All right, take care.